I am honored to stand before you and be part of such a very important event here at Rochester Middle School. Tonight's ceremony is a celebration of the hard work which each student sitting here has given. However, this honor is a representation of more than just their academic success. We are asking these students this evening to also agree to serve as leaders within the community and the school building and to represent Rochester Middle School and are committing to giving back to both the school and the community. To the parents, guardians, and family members present this evening, a sincere thank you to you as well. It is with your support and your guidance that you give every day to your student, which makes this evening possible. Tonight's ceremony is an example of how it truly takes a village to raise a child, and for your support and efforts, we are most grateful. At this time, I'd like to ask that our assistant principal, Oscar Haas, come forward and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, as well as a moment of silence.
Can you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated.
There were several adults who made this evening possible. Some of them are here in the chairs beside me. Others are seated in this gymnasium. I would ask that all of those who work directly with the students each day please take a moment to stand and be recognized. So if you're anywhere throughout the district within Rochester Schools and you work with these students or have a direct impact with the students, whether it's teachers, IAs, custodial, we would like for you to stand and recognize as we know that it's truly a village that raises these children. So if those people would stand up and work with them daily, including those behind me that work with them. I see several of you out there. You guys need to stand and be recognized, please. Yes, stand and be recognized. Thank you for your help and support. I would like to introduce those who made this evening possible. Our council advisors, Mrs. Cassie Murphy, Ms. Tammy Paul, and Mrs. Tricia Setterholm. Just as we ask each student to give of their time and talents, we do the same with our National Junior Honor Society sponsors. Each of these ladies is giving of their time and their talents. NJHS is one of the few groups or organizations within the district which does not pay their sponsors a stipend. So just as we're asking the students, we're also asking the adults to give, so it's truly an effort of leadership and leading by example. They are doing this because they believe in what the organization has to offer and because they agree that these students deserve this recognition and support as they continue to grow this academic year. Each of you has given of your time, energy, and talent to make this happen, and I want to give a sincere thank you to each one of you. Tonight's ceremony is meant to be a dignified event. With that, I would gently remind you to make sure that you've silenced all your electronic devices. We'll try to move this through quickly. I know it's hot and uncomfortable in here, but if you would help by silencing those devices. In addition, I want to share with you one of my greatest fears and concerns, and that is that a family will not be able to hear their child's name or see their child be recognized as we move through the line. So with so many being inducted this evening, we would ask that you hold your applause until everybody has had that opportunity so that all parents and guardians can hear their child's name being announced. And then at the end, we'll give you a time to honor all of them as they get ready to leave the gym. But for now, if we can hold those off until the end, that would be greatly appreciated. At this time, I'll turn this over to Mrs. Cassie Murphy, our lead sponsor, and she's going to lead us through the ceremony.
Since 1929, the National Junior Honor Society has been a prestigious organization and is more than just an honor roll. Membership carries with it a recognition that is nationwide. NJHS seeks to create an enthusiasm for superior scholarship, develop citizenship, promote leadership and service opportunities, and instill exemplary qualities of character. Through NJHS activities, members maintain and extend the qualities that earn them selection. Membership is both an honor and a commitment. The candles will now be lit for each of the qualities that stand for the emblem of National Junior Honor Society. Scholarship is the total academic performance as demonstrated by the grades received by the students while in attendance at the school for the second semester of their seventh grade year. Leadership is considered highly important for membership selection. The Faculty Council needs to make sure each student has shown leadership skills at RMS. Service is considered to be those actions undertaken by the students which are done with or on behalf of others without any direct financial or material compensation. Citizenship is when the students demonstrate an understanding of the community involvement, participates in school activities, and holds a respect for the freedom and justice of our country. Finally, character is a blend of all the qualities mentioned. It is composed of many attitudes which influence the decisions you make. Your character is bound in a moral and ethical framework. At this time, I would like to introduce Tammy Paul, who will introduce our past officers, to pin our new officers for this year.
I'd like to thank all the former officers for conducting their duties with the council by coming to this induction ceremony to pass the torch on to the next group of officers. Starting us out is former President Michael Bays.
It's my pleasure to ask Ethan Trottier to come forward. Ethan, do you agree to uphold the duties and responsibilities of the presidential portion of NJHS?
Yes, I agree.
Vice President.
I'm honored to ask Emma Dahlquist to come forward at this time. Emma, do you agree to support Ethan as president and the NJHS group in leading as vice president?
Yes, I agree.
Former Secretary Zach Brown.
As the former secretary, I will ask Abby McCarter to come forward at this time. Abby, do you agree to do the duties and responsibilities of the secretary position?
Yes, I agree.
Former Treasurer Graham Goss.
I would invite Kelsey Tyler to come forward. Kelsey, do you agree to fulfill the duties of Treasurer?
Yes, I agree.
Former Sergeant of Arms, Carlton Mullett.
Would Corey Roush please join me?
agree to follow the guidelines and procedures for the duty of Sergeant of Arms?
Yes, I agree.
And finally, our historian, Claire Dunwoody.
We have two ladies to take the oath for historian. Madison Shively and Olivia Jennings, please come forward. Do you, Madison and Olivia, agree to capture all the moments of your journey through NJHS this year?
Yes, I agree.
Yes, I agree.
At this time, would all NJHS candidates please rise for the lighting of the candles? At this time, I will ask each member to repeat the NJHS pledge after me. I pledge to uphold the high purposes of the National Junior Honor Society, to which I have been selected. I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to my school. And will maintain and encourage high standards of scholarship, leadership, service, citizenship, and character. At this time, members, please extinguish your candles and have a seat in preparation for the certificates and recognition. Aya Abdallah. Trey Adley. Alex Adrianoff. Sarah Avery. Bree Bailey. Alyssa Bell. Allie Bickle. Brene Bickle. Madison Booth. Melissa Bradley. Chase Brown. Jayla Burkett. Allie Byerline. Kiana Kennedy. Evan Cashin. Emma Dahlquist. Kyla Ellinger. Alexis Elliott. Brittany Fresh. Jacob Good. Shiloh Guerra. Caitlin Hyde Moore. Jeffrey Harrell. Maria Hunting. Olivia Jennings. Morgan Leslie. Jordan Lewis. Becky Long. Abby McCarter. Erica McClellan.
Matthew Miller. Kennedy Musselman. Megan Nard. Ashley Navarro. Rachel Nelson. Nathan Patterson. Grace Paul. Alan Piper. Grace Piper. Justin Thune. Ian Pugh. Raven Reese. Jordan Reinhold. Corey Roush. Jeffrey Rupert. Maddie Sailors. Amanda Sager. Sarah Schaller. Schultz. Paige Schaefer. Amber Scheidler. Maddie Shively. Alyssa Solis. Nicole Spencer. Anthony Tensman. Ethan Trottier. Emily Tyler. Kelsey Tyler. Cherokee White Knight. Amber Weller. Willard.
You can go ahead and honor those students. I can't help but think the whole time she's taking pictures that it's my former science teacher bailing me out of trouble and how many sentences I had to write in her class many, many years ago. But thank you. I don't know if I'm supposed to say that or not, but as the principal of the school, I did have to write sentences. Members of National Junior Honor Society, I would like to remind you that with recognition comes responsibility. Your induction this evening was not a culmination point, but rather your starting point. Your charge now is to fulfill your pledge, and that starts this evening. And yet I would like to remind you that you are not alone. Please look around this gymnasium. You are surrounded by adults who care and are invested in your futures, and you should feel proud. Let's honor all of these students at this time. Support. I know it's hot in here. I assure you it's much, much cooler in the commons area, but if you'd like to join us for cake and punch, we would love the chance to meet the parents and get to greet you and get to know you a little bit better and honor your students by having a gathering out in the cafeteria area. So students, if you'd like to stand and exit first, and then we'll ask the parents and guardians meet you after everybody has cleared the gym. That'll give them a chance to go out this. If you want to line up and go out this back door, please, Ethan, if you want to lead, and then they can follow behind. And once they're out, we'll ask parents if you join us in the commons area. Again, thank you for your time this evening.